Jesus went through a lot of persecution. They lied about him. They watched him in his words. Then if he didn't say anything they couldn't use. Hey, you know what's funny? ABC with their hidden camera up in Tulsa accidentally left their camera on in the backseat of their car, and we got the conversation of what they were saying in the backseat of the car, and they got a problem. Can you? Dumb, dumb, dumb. Everybody say the devil is dumb. See, Bob, should you tell about that? Well, we played it to the judge. Here come the judge. We played it to the judge. He heard it. Played it to the press that was there. They heard it. Played it to all those attorneys that were there to see this other attorney wax eloquent against JC. They didn't see that happen. Oh, it's looking good. I see the victory. I see the hundredfold return. Yes, I see the church growing. I see the television ministry exploding around the world. I see crusades happening and people being healed like popcorn. I see millions being saved and brought into the kingdom of heaven. I see it. I see victory in every lawsuit. I see victory over ABC. I see ABC paying out a lot of money. A lot of money. I hear the sound of abundance. I hear the sound of abundance over you and your family and your marriage and your household. See what's happening with this music? Always know everything. What did Jesus say after the little woman touched him and was healed? What did Jesus say? Did you hear that? Why in the world would Jesus say, "Who touched me?" Think about that. Jesus knew a woman had been healed, but he didn't know which one it was. Now, I'm not going to make a big doctrine off of this, but Jesus did say, "Who touched me?" And if someone says, "Who touched me?" it seems to me they didn't know who it was. Hello? Now, how many of you realize there's been some persecution on me in this church? And I'm not looking for no pie in the sky, even though I got one in the face. But I see something. I see victory. Thus saith the Lord. In life, you'll have some problems and trials and tribulations, but thus saith the Lord, I've overcome them all. And the overcomer lives on the inside of me. Does he live on the inside of you? I said, does he live on the inside of you? Are you sure? I said, are you sure? You gotta get violent in your spirit. I had a little violent attack the other day. This attorney was being nasty, saying some nasty things about this church and me. And you. I'm in this boardroom, supposed to be nice, behaving myself, and JC's on one side and I'm on the other side. And that guy said something I didn't like, and I don't know what happened. But the next thing I know, I'm on my feet and I got my finger in his face telling him he's lying. He says, don't point your finger at me. I said, I can point something else at you if you want to. God forgive me. And I did apologize. We did shake hands. I know someone else like that, Peter. He wanted to cut somebody's ear off one time. He even wanted to call. He says, can we call fire down from heaven like Elijah? I thought about calling some fire down. I'll let y'all figure out the locations. Fire of the Holy Ghost. You reporters out there, don't you edit up this stuff. I'll come after you. I got a lot of attorneys, and this church got a lot of money. So don't mess with us. This week, JC comes in, and you can sit down if you want to. This week, JC, what are you standing up for anyway? You're the strangest bunch of people that come to church. We spend all this money on these expensive chairs, and you stand up. I mean, all these expensive chairs, and you stand up. Oh, look, a guy can't, look, there's one over there. He just can't sit still. All these expensive chairs, and you stand up. Why do you want to do that? Huh? Holy Ghost on you? Fire burning in your bones? Like fire burning in your bones? Something inside of me telling me, go ahead. Rock and roll. Standing on the rock and my name's on the roll. Please sit down. Most preachers work their entire life preaching, never get anybody on their feet. Elijah, been through thick and thin. Watch that prophet of God do all kinds of things. Raise the dead. Talk to the dead. I mean, Jesus even talked to the dead. One of my attorneys gets all upset when I was talking about raising the dead. But I can't help it. It's in the Bible. I mean, Jesus talked to the dead. Jesus talked to the dead.